our kids are dying to senseless violence. We show a little bit of action, then a whole lot of silence.
Yeah.
I was told that prayer changes things, so I'ma change the way I pray and go against the grain and pray for the world. Yeah,
pray
for the world. Like I pray for myself. Said I pray for the world,
pray
for the world, but the whole world needs help, hey,
so much help.
Where are the Malcolms and where are the Martins? Where are the Marvins singing songs like what's going on?
What's going on?
We got natural disasters, nuclear attackers, falling pastors. Still it's God that I'm after. I hate traffic, all these women in traffic, being sold for nothing, it's somebody's lustful habits.
We can't be silent.
And I'm not saying start a riot. We gotta let go of the wheel and let God be the pilot.
Oh,
hey, pray for the world. Like I pray for myself. Said I pray for the world. Said I pray for the world. But the whole world needs help. Said I pray for the world. Pray up for the world. Like I pray for myself. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Said I pray for the world. Hands up for the world. The whole world needs help. Said the whole world needs help. I can't lie and say I'm not in need, but the world won't change if I just pray for me. Unselfishly, we have to intercede. Intercede. The whole world needs help. Anymore. Our kids can't go to the movies, that school, or the store. In every city, in every country, there is war. We need the Lord. We must stand together, hand in hand, and pray one day the world will change, so we won't have to deal with this again. And the next time you pray for yourself, know someone has got it worse. And before you end your prayer and say amen, say I pray for the world.
Pray
for the world.
Pray.
Like I pray for myself. Pray for the world. Pray the for the world.
Pray.
Hey, the world needs help. The world needs help. The whole world needs help. Hey, anybody wanna pray now? Anybody wanna pray now? Oh Lord, Lord. World needs help. Every prayer is needed. The whole world needs help. Yes, Lord. Hey. Help me out, say.
The whole world needs help.
Hey, say the whole world, yeah.
The whole world needs help.
Everywhere in the world, say.
The whole world needs help.
The world, the world.
The whole world needs help.
Said the whole world needs help. Yeah.
The whole world needs help.
Over in Africa. Over in Syria.
Whole world needs
right
help.
Here in America. The whole world needs help.
Whole world
every
needs
city,
help.
Every ghetto, every hood. Yeah.
The whole world.
Good evening, everyone. I am so glad you all are here. And it looks like I am live also on YouTube, but I think YouTube is taking over my camera. So I'm actually going to cut off the live feed to YouTube so that I can see your faces. And I will deal with that later. Let's see. Wonderful. Good evening. Good evening. So we are going to spend some time in prayer, but I wanted to welcome you all tonight. Thank you all so much for coming. And I will close down the room. So I know there are some people that are probably trying to join, but I will lock it in once we start praying so that we can focus and not have distractions. So tonight I want to acknowledge that there may be many faith traditions and cultures on the line, from those who are quiet and reserved to charismatic and vocal, from those who pray with silent tears and expressions of joy to those who pray openly and in their heavenly language. I also want to acknowledge the limitations of the Zoom platform, which doesn't really work well when everyone's mic is open while one person is speaking. So what I've done is I've muted all the lines to invite a space where we can all just hear one speaker or hear just the music, and it allows you to have your private time in prayer. But I do encourage you to use the chat to share any expressions of praise or thankfulness, or if you want to send over a prayer request, you can do so. I'd also like to acknowledge that there may be people on the call who are at their limit in life, or they're here because they're standing in the gap from someone or someone that they know. And one thing I know is that prayer definitely works, and it can go where we cannot, and prayer can do what we cannot do. And so in addition to prayer, God has given us tangible resources to work through difficult moments in our lives. And so I want to share three numbers with you that you can text or call right from your phone to have a conversation to get further help for yourself or for your loved one if needed. That number is available 24/7, 365 days of the year, and it's 988. The number is 988. So if you have not already done so, I invite you to share any prayer requests that you may have via the link in the chat. And in a moment, we will begin to call the names in prayer, and we will get started. So our theme for tonight, and I'm going to drop it in the chat one more time, actually, just to make sure everyone is seeing it. But our theme for tonight is peace. God hears us, and God sees us. And I love to pray scripture. So I'm going to be reading actually from Philippians 4, chapter 4, verses 6 through 8 in the New Living Translation. And it reads, "Do not worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. Tell God what you need and thank Him for all He has done. Then you will experience God's peace, which exceeds anything we can understand. His peace will guard our hearts and our minds as we live in Christ Jesus." And now, dear brothers and sisters, there's one final thing. Let's focus our thoughts on what is true, what is honorable, what is right, what is pure, lovely, and admirable. And let's think about these things that are excellent and worthy of praise. So I'm just going to take a moment and check to see if any additional prayer requests. All right, we are good to go. So no additional prayer requests came in. All right. So let us pray. God, we thank you. We thank you for seeing us and hearing us. More specifically, we acknowledge that at times it is difficult to believe or accept that you hear us and that you see us. But even in those moments, God, we thank you that you strengthen our faith to hold on just a little while longer. God, you strengthen our faith to continue trusting you through the process, no matter how difficult it may seem. Specifically, Lord, as young people and young adults, we are seeing and experiencing things we've mostly only read about in accounts of history or heard about from our parents and our relatives. We are experiencing the realities of war, violence, racism, and so many other isms that are just unnerving. We are saddened and heartbroken by the unnecessary death seemingly day in and day out. At the end of the day, Lord, we all just really want our innate need met, and that is to be seen, feel seen, and live peaceably. Lord, we gather tonight in solidarity for a better world, a peaceful world, and accept that it starts with each and every one of us individually. Remind us that it is the collective nature of our individual decisions and behaviors that reflect the nature and culture of our neighborhoods, which in turn reflect the collective behaviors and culture of what become our communities. And it is our collective community behavior that reflects the culture of what become our state, which in turn reflects the culture and the behavior of our nation and the world. Remind us, Lord, that we really are our brother and our sister's keeper, and that we can turn things around one individual decision and action at a time. And as we seek to do this, Lord, we pray for your guidance. We pray for peace. We pray for our ability to extend grace one to another. Lord, we pray for you to heal the hearts and minds of all affected by wars around the globe. Go into each secret place of political decision making and where the decision making makers are, and speak to their hearts in their minds as only you can. And do the same for those who have influence with them and among them. Help them to do what is right by humanity simply because it is right in Jesus' name. And Lord, would you help our hearts? Help us to cope in healthy ways as we watch our parents' generation and many within our own generation make decisions in high places that impact us all. We pray for every voice that is being amplified on college campuses and around the world to end mass killings and destructions. We pray for every student on every campus, Lord, that they will have safety as they traverse the campus, no matter their ethnicity or their religious affiliation. We pray for their families impacted by wars around the globe. We pray for the communities impacted and those left in ruins as a result of the wars and disagreements. We pray that we will use our words to discuss our differences rather than machinery. We pray that we will see that our differences actually make us better together if we would stop long enough to respect and learn how to do life together. Lord, as young people, our hearts long for a world that demonstrates love and kindness consistently. We thank you because we know that you hear us and that you see us, no matter how difficult or scary things may seem. In Jesus' name, amen. And so the next prayer is a pastoral prayer that I've adapted in honor of Mental Health Awareness Month, but I would like to pray for all of those who have mental health challenges for any number of reasons, whether it's because they have a medical ailment, because they have diagnoses of mental health disorders, because trauma has happened in their lives, any number of reasons. So we want to pray this prayer. And then what I will do is provide a food item that you can drink or eat, totally up to you, to help you in moments of high stress or anxiety to help calm you down. So that is going to be our next prayer. Let us pray. Loving Creator, we come to you on this day of prayer for mental health, mental illness, recovery, and for the understanding of the same, because we know that you are a God of love and compassion. Lord, we come as people of all creeds and all nations, seeking your presence, comfort, and guidance. We come as consumers, family members, friends, co-workers, and mental health professionals. We come this day because we believe you, Lord. We believe you love each and every one of us, and that you walk with us on our individual journeys in life. You see the ignorance and injustice that divides and separates people who struggle with their mental health and or even with mental illness. God, you see the tears and feel the heartache of those struggling with their mental health. Would you please give us courage, Lord, to face these challenges and open our hearts to the many ways you are already working in our midst. Help us to identify mental illness as the disease that it is, that we might have the courage and wisdom in the face of ignorance and stigma to seek help and or help those in need. Inspire us as we seek to overcome fear, gain the knowledge and the ability to advocate for compassionate, respectful, and culturally relevant and appropriate treatment and services for those who need it. Lead us, Lord, as we open our hearts and homes, our communities and job opportunities, our houses of worship, and communities of faith to embrace those with mental and emotional needs. Enable us to find ways to be inclusive for our brothers and sisters living with mental illness in our everyday lives. Be with the doctors, the therapists, the researchers, the social workers, the nutritionists, and all those in the helping professions as they seek to overcome ignorance and injustice with care and compassion while supporting culturally appropriate, humane, and respectful recovery. And while we may feel discouraged and hopeless in the face of so many challenges from time to time, help us all to see ourselves as you see us, Lord, human persons of value and worth, and human persons of creativity and potential. May we come to understand the interconnectedness of mind, body, and spirit in bringing about health and wholeness. And may we go forward in our communities and the spaces we do life with a renewed sense of vision, hope, purpose, and possibility for the future. And it is in Jesus' name we pray with thanksgiving. Thank God. Amen. All right, so at this time, what I'm going to do is share a food that you can use in a couple different ways to help with calm. And believe it or not, I'm sure many of you have heard of ginger. Ginger comes as like a hard root. It comes in a powder. It comes pickled. You may get that with sushi sometime. But ginger is really a relaxing food that the Lord has given us. So a couple of things that ginger does is anti-inflammatory. So if you have a cold, you can drink ginger tea that can help with some relief. If you have nausea or you're really worked up, you can drink some ginger to help calm down. And actually research shows ginger does better than Dramamine and other motion sickness type, you know, pharmaceuticals, because it's just that powerful. So God knew we were going to need something to help us calm down. He sent us ginger. When you have upset tummy, so like gastrointestinal distress, such as gas or bloating, you can drink ginger tea, warm ginger tea, and it will help resolve that as well. If you have trouble falling asleep at night, ginger is a nice relaxing tea to drink before bed. I would probably say an hour, just so you can go to the bathroom before you go to bed, so you don't have to get up and, you know, tinkle. And then there's one other thing about ginger I want to share. If you have osteoarthritis or rheumatoid arthritis, ginger has very powerful, a very powerful component called gingerols, which actually helps reduce the pain level for those who suffer from inflamed joint areas for any number of reasons. So throughout this week, as we're praying, you know, it's Mental Health Awareness Month, but life is still life for a lot of us. So consider drinking some ginger tea. You can also get fresh ginger and cut it up and put it in your food. You can put it as a powder on just about anything. It complements very well in gently pan-seared or gently stir-fried things. I don't usually advocate for fries, but I do know it pairs really well with it. So that is it for our prayer call tonight. I'm going to check one more thing to make sure no more prayer requests came in. Very good. And I'm going to actually unmute, and if there are any prayer requests on the call, we can accept them now. And we will pray, we will call your name, we will remember you. And I'm trying to do these things. I think I did it. So you have that, you should have the option now to unmute. Thank you all for joining too.
Excuse me, when you said ginger tea, are you talking about using the root to make the tea or the tea bag, if you will?
You know, you can use either one. I've done it both ways. I'll tell you, it's very powerful. You buy the ginger root, you can wash it and leave the skin on or off. It's totally up to you. But I like the flavor a lot better from the ginger root than it being ground up in the bag. But either whatever's easiest for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I'd like to thank you for inviting me. I've been watching you for quite some time, and of course, you know that I love you and I love your entire family. And I just wanted to say thank you for your help, because you are helping me to eat healthier one meal at a time. And I just wanted to let you know that I lost 2 pounds in 3 days.
Oh, wow.
Fresh fruits and vegetables. Not to say that I haven't had any protein, because I've had a very little. I'm trying to wean myself off of it. But I just want to let you know that what you're doing is so amazing. I'm so proud of you. And I just want to thank you for just keeping it going. You know, and you always in my prayers.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate that. And that's such a blessing to hear. It's like music to my ears, you know, just to try it out. And it's good. And just keep moving forward. You know, it's just about eating more plants. I'm not trying to take anybody's animals away.
Yeah.
But it's definitely eating more plants. You know, God gave us plants, and we are what I call constitutional omnivores, so our bodies can adapt. Doesn't mean that we should let it adapt to everything, but we were designed to thrive off of plants. And so I always advocate for eating more at every meal and at every snack to give your body exactly what it needs, which are the phytonutrients and chemicals that come, phytochemicals, when you say it that way, which are plant chemicals, right, that come to help us thrive and to help us, you know, avoid a lot of chronic disease.
I would say that I am surprisingly happy about it, because the food is good, it's delicious. the combinations together that I really never really thought about, I'm sold.
That's wonderful. Thank you for sharing so much.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Miss Nelson?
Good evening, everyone. Good evening, Ethel.
Name.
I just wanted to ask about the different kind of preparations for ginger. Like, do you still get the benefits from pickled ginger?
You definitely still get benefits from pickled ginger. I would really look at the container to see what they're storing it in, though, to make sure it's not maybe a lot of salt, a sulfur type things. Just try to look for a clean one. The one I bought for a client was it's literally just like water and ginger, and maybe like a vitamin C type of preservative in there. So it was like the least. The path least resistance. And I could email you the actual brand I bought to give you an idea of where you could potentially start.
Okay.
Pickle
ginger. That's
So I
interesting.
like getting my stir fries. So I
Amen.
just wanted to
Amen.
make sure I'm still getting the same benefits.
Good
Yeah, of
idea.
course, anytime we cook something, we lose a little bit of micronutrients, but usually not to the point where it doesn't make sense that it's still not needed. And sometimes when we cook food, it actually amplifies certain things. So just one of those things where you're going to get a benefit either.
All right.
Amen.
Excellent.
Well, thank you all so much for joining. I
Yeah.
want to pause the recording because I want to share something with you, but I don't want it recorded. About who Ms. Nelson is. But thank you all for joining. And next Thursday, we'll be back at 7 p.m. We'll be praying again. Please share it with your youth groups and young people and young adults. Really just a safe place to pause. But I know that there are some people who couldn't come tonight. So the recording allows us to make it available for a replay later.